We're gonna make a ham and egg omelet. We've got our eggs with a splash of milk. We've got our onions that we grated up. We've got our chopped ham that we chopped from yesterday's Thanksgiving and butter. We're just gonna whip up the eggs and the milk. In a hot pan with butter. This is the perfect size for an omelet because you're gonna have to swish it around and around and around. Pour in your eggs. I'm going to put in a little Himalayan salt. It's better for you than regular salt. Assimilates into your body better. You're going to lift your skillet and you're going to go slowly around, not letting it go out of the pan, your eggs. Getting closer. Takes a little while to get the omelet cooked. Almost there. I've turned my heat down from fairly high to medium now. Just letting the eggs get fully cooked. The edges will fall away on its own when it gets done. You see, this was not quite ready. It will push away when as it gets done, you'll be able to just fold it over. Not quite ready. It will begin to go ahead and pull prime naturally from the pan. Once it gets done, as you can see, it's browning. We're gonna go ahead and put our onions in first. And we will be adding cheese to this one. You can put any ingredients you want. Mushrooms, tomatoes, anything that you really like.
Bell peppers. And it's gonna be good.
I'm going to add our cheese. This is a Colby cheese. You can put whatever kind of cheese you prefer. And we're gonna add our ham. Got us a little chunk in there. Not quite ready to fold over, you'll know, because the bottom underneath here will look browner, more brown. We're going to go ahead and fold it over. That's going to look great.
Good.
Let the ingredients cook just a little more. We'll turn it down, turn it off. Get ready. We're going to put it on its plate over here. And there you have.
That looks good.
Here's our omelet on a plate with toast the day after Thanksgiving.
It's good.